Welcome back to acid-based titrations, where we're focusing on strong acid with strong-based titrations. We're going to start our section by describing what we have in solution by talking about beaker drawings. Normally in a regular semester, I would do all four of these drawings that you see on the screen. In the interest of time, we're going to focus on just doing the drawing for number two. So again, remember here, we're working with hydrochloric acid titrated with sodium hydroxide. And so I want to draw what happens when I have 2 moles of HCl titrated with 1 mole of the base. For our beaker drawing, I'm actually going to start by drawing a change table. And you can tell it's me because I still can't draw aqueous even on a regular screen. Sorry for the extra glitchy marks on here. I don't know how to get rid of those. I'm assuming I'll get better at this soon. Hopefully. All right, so we have our chemical equation. Remember, in our change table, our labels are I, C, and F. That's an F for final. And so again, I'm going to start with 2 moles of HCl. I'm going to add 1 mole of NaOH. And because this is the very beginning of my reaction, I don't have any products that I'm starting with. I'm going to draw my line down the middle under my arrow. And then remember, the key thing in a change table is that we figure out the amount of change by determining our limiting reactant. Since sodium hydroxide has the smaller amount, I can label it as my limiting reactant. Therefore, I know that it's going to go to zero, and then everything has to change by 1 mole. So remember, reactants decrease, products increase, and then that allows me to figure out how much I have left in solution. So I have 1 mole of HCl, 1 mole of NaCl, and 1 mole of H2O. But of course, we also should recognize that because NaCl and H2O are neutral, although I have them in solution, they will not be affecting my pH. So very important to keep in mind. To draw this solution in a beaker then, my resulting solution, I have 1 mole of HCl, which as a strong acid we know completely dissociates. And then we have our 1 mole of NaCl and 1 mole of H2O. But again, as we already discussed, those are neutral. So although I have them in solution, they will not be affecting my pH. So at this point in a titration, the key thing that affects my pH is how much excess HCl is left over in solution. For our titrations, we can identify where we are in a titration two ways. One is because we've calculated our equivalence point, we know that the volume of base, the volume is on the x-axis, the volume of base needed to reach our equivalence point occurred at 25 milliliters. And so I know as long as I'm before that equivalence point, I'm going to have excess acid in solution. So that beaker drawing we just did is an example of that. And any point after the equivalence point will have excess base in solution. So the 4 points that we have in a titration are before we add any base, 0.1, 0 mils of base, really we just have acid in solution. Region 2 is where we have excess acid, so before our equivalence point. So anything from 0 to 25, we're going to calculate at 10. At the equivalence point, again, when we have stoichiometric equivalence of acid and base, for all of our reactions, since they're a 1-to-1 ratio, that means we have exactly equal moles of acid and base. And then we'll calculate after the equivalence point. What I want you to work on is setting up a change table for points 2 through 4. We don't need one for number 1 because there's no reaction occurring. So remember, for these change tables, this is where we have 0.10 molar, 25 mils of HCl, and we're titrating this with 0.10 molar NaOH. So at the end of this video, I want you to set up 3 change tables to start to identify what is in solution with these volumes of base at 10, 25, and 30. When we come back, I will show you the